caused big cap stocks to get obliterated. How could Amazon stock tumble 2.4%? How could Apple stock lose 2%? How could Microsoft fall 2.5%? And holy heck, Batman, what explains NVIDIA's 5.5% dive?
Showing retail sales were unexpectedly flat last month as inflation-weary consumers cut back spending at online retailers and auto dealerships.
The financial world is buzzing with news that has sent shockwaves through Wall Street and beyond. Goldman Sachs, one of the most influential investment banks globally, has issued a stark warning that has caught the attention of investors, analysts, and financial media. This warning isn't just another market forecast. It's accompanied by actionable moves that have raised eyebrows and concerns across the financial sector. The investment giant is making headlines by offloading a significant portion of its holdings, prompting many to ask, what does this mean for the market, and why now? Goldman Sachs, one of the most influential financial institutions, has recently sold off substantial amounts of its tech stocks. This decision has sent ripples through the market, causing a stir among investors and analysts alike. Historically, hedge funds and retail investors have often been on opposite sides of trades. A notable instance was during the last major market rally, when retail investors outperformed the professionals by buying into stocks that hedge funds were selling. However, this time around, it appears hedge funds, including those associated with Goldman Sachs, believe they have the upper hand. Goldman's move comes at a time when the market is experiencing significant shifts. The top five mega-cap tech stocks have reached new highs, drawing in retail investors eager to capitalize on the bullish trend. However, Goldman Sachs's analysts warn that this scenario might be setting up retail investors for a downfall. Retail investors have been heavily buying into these high-performing tech stocks, largely driven by their recent success and the hope that the market will continue to climb. This positive outlook is evident in the consistent purchase of leveraged long ETFs, despite an overall decrease in trading activity among individual investors. This buying spree is particularly concerning given the current economic indicators suggesting a downturn. Retail sales and consumer spending. One critical factor that Goldman Sachs and other hedge funds are likely considering is the recent retail sales and consumer spending data. For example, Walgreens, a major retail chain, recently reported a 4% decline in retail sales from the previous year. This drop indicates a challenging consumer environment contrary to the bullish expectations of retail investors. The assumption that consumer spending would rebound in the second half of the year has not materialized. This miscalculation has significant implications for corporate earnings and stock prices. Corporate earnings and buybacks. Corporate share buybacks, a significant driver of stock prices, are also in a blackout period. With companies like Walgreens signaling a challenging environment and cutting back on buybacks, the market could see a substantial reduction in one of its primary support mechanisms. Hedge fund strategy. Hedge funds, including those associated with Goldman Sachs, seem to be positioning themselves to take advantage of a possible market correction. By selling off high-performing tech stocks now, they are locking in profits and avoiding what they perceive as an imminent downturn. Tech stocks and market concentration. The concentration of market value in the top 10% of stocks is reminiscent of previous bubble periods, such as in 1928 and the late 1990s. Hedge funds are aware of this and are acting accordingly. On the other hand, retail investors seem to be buying into these stocks at their peak, a strategy that historically leads to significant losses when the bubble bursts. Labor market and unemployment. Another critical factor influencing Goldman's decision is the state of the labor market. Recent data shows an increase in recurring jobless claims, reaching levels not seen since the end of 2021. This rise in unemployment claims suggests that the labor market is softening, which could lead to reduced consumer spending and further economic slowdown. Inflation and interest rates. Inflation and interest rates also play crucial roles. Although inflation has shown signs of cooling, the current interest rates remain restrictive. This environment makes borrowing more expensive, reducing consumer and business spending and ultimately slowing economic growth, GDP, and corporate profits. The final estimate of the first quarter GDP has been revised slightly, but still indicates slowing economic growth. Corporate profits, a key driver of stock prices, have also shown signs of decline. According to the latest data, corporate profits have decreased by 2.7% quarter over quarter. This decline is a significant concern for investors who buy stocks based on the expectation of growing profits. The AI bubble. The AI artificial intelligence bubble is one of the more speculative elements currently driving market optimism. Retail investors are pouring money into AI-related stocks, hoping for outsized returns. However, hedge funds and market analysts are skeptical. They recognize that while AI has long-term potential, the current valuations might not be sustainable, especially in a slowing economy. Despite these concerns, market sentiment among retail investors remains bullish. Many believe the market will continue to rise, driven by the same forces that have driven it so far. However, the reality might be starkly different. Goldman's warnings and actions have varied impacts across different investor categories. Institutional investors may reassess portfolio allocations, increase focus on risk management and hedging strategies, and shift away from momentum-based approaches. Retail investors might grow concerned about the stability of tech-heavy portfolios, show increased interest in diversification and professional advice, and reassess long-term investment strategies. Hedge funds face pressure to reevaluate positions, especially in crowded trades, with an increased focus on macro trends and policy shifts, seizing opportunities for contrarian strategies as market dynamics change. Pension funds and long-term investors must balance short-term volatility concerns with their long-term mandates, increasing alternative investment allocations for diversification and reassessing expected returns and funding ratios. Goldman's warning and actions should be understood in the wider context of the global economy. The world is still recovering unevenly from the COVID-19 pandemic, with different sectors and regions progressing at varying rates. Central banks are facing challenges in determining the appropriate timing and method of normalizing monetary policies without jeopardizing fragile economic recoveries. Uncertainties surrounding government spending and taxation further complicate economic predictions. Moreover, ongoing technological advancements are disrupting industries and business models, leading to increased unpredictability. Goldman's recent actions indicate significant long-term shifts in market dynamics. This signals an end to tech dominance, ushering in a more balanced market where other sectors gain prominence. This may lead to a resurgence of value investing strategies, which have underperformed for years. As major market players repositioned, we could see prolonged periods of increased market volatility. Additionally, the effectiveness of passive index-based investing strategies may come under scrutiny in this more volatile environment, prompting a shift back to fundamental analysis and away from momentum-based trading strategies. Goldman warns us to be cautious, but it also highlights opportunities despite challenges. Investors must navigate increased market volatility, reassess risk tolerance and investment strategies, and adapt to shifts in economic policies and market dynamics. However, this changing situation also presents opportunities such as identifying undervalued assets, exploring new sectors and investment themes, and leveraging advanced analytics and AI for deeper market insights. Technology and data analytics play a critical role in this era of uncertainty. The AI-driven analysis processes vast amounts of data, and high-frequency trading impacts market volatility and liquidity. Investors increasingly rely on alternative data sources for market trends and company performance insights. Blockchain and decentralized finance can change financial markets, adding complexity to future market dynamics. Initially centered on U.S. markets, Goldman Sachs's warning carries profound global implications. First, emerging markets face heightened volatility as global investment flows redirect. Second, there may be significant impacts on currency valuations, particularly affecting export-reliant nations and those heavily reliant on foreign investments. Third, shifts in market dynamics could reshape international trade patterns and disrupt global supply chains. Lastly, central banks globally may be compelled to adjust their monetary policies in response to these major market shifts. Amidst all the data and analysis, the psychological aspects of market behavior play a crucial role. Market sentiment is often driven by fear and greed, as highlighted by Goldman's recent warning, which could intensify market apprehensions and trigger exaggerated reactions. Additionally, the herd mentality among investors tends to amplify market swings, as individuals often follow prevailing trends rather than making independent decisions. Confirmation bias further complicates matters, as investors may interpret information in ways that affirm their preconceived notions about market trends. Moreover, anchoring bias can delay adjustments to new information, causing slower responses to evolving market dynamics. Goldman's warning and actions also have implications for regulators and policymakers. Market stability concerns. Regulators may increase scrutiny of market practices and systemic risks, monetary policy considerations. Central banks may need to reassess their strategies in light of shifting market dynamics. Fiscal policy debates. The market turmoil could influence discussions on government spending, taxation, and economic stimulus measures. Financial sector oversight. Increased attention to the activities of major financial institutions and their impact on market stability. The key takeaway from Goldman's actions should be caution for retail investors. Their enthusiasm for high-performing tech stocks might be misplaced if the broader economic indicators point towards a slowdown. Diversify and be prepared. Investors should consider diversifying their portfolios to hedge against possible downturns. Holding a mix of asset classes, including bonds, commodities, and defensive stocks, can provide some protection against market volatility. Stay informed. Keeping up with economic indicators and market trends is essential for informed investment decisions. Consult with financial advisors. Finally, consulting with financial advisors can provide personalized advice tailored to individual investment goals and risk tolerance. A professional can offer insights and strategies that might not be apparent to the average investor. Goldman Sachs' recent sell-off signals that market conditions might not be as favorable as they appear. By paying attention to these warnings and adjusting strategies accordingly, investors can better navigate the uncertain times ahead. The tug of war between retail investors' exuberance and institutional investors' caution highlights the fragility of current market conditions. As economic indicators point towards headwinds and uncertainties, prudent risk management becomes crucial for investors of all stripes. The coming months will likely clarify whether this sell-off is a temporary adjustment or the beginning of a more significant market correction. Goldman Sachs' warning and action signal a significant moment in market dynamics. For investors, this emphasizes the importance of diversification, risk management, and staying informed about economic trends. For policymakers, it is a call to vigilance. Ultimately, Goldman's warning highlights the need for adaptability in investment strategies. The financial sector is evolving, and being informed and prudent will be crucial for navigating future opportunities and challenges.